Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Welcome to this session, and this session we'll discuss about corporate social responsibility, typically how Indian companies are doing their CSR, and also we'll briefly understand what is social sustainability and try to also understand the difference between the corporate social responsibility and the corporate social sustainability, because most of the time it is being used closely, but you will find also there are certain differences there between the corporate social responsibility and corporate social sustainability. So what it means when we say corporate social responsibility, possibly we everyone understand what it means or how it is being operationalized. So it is a continuing commitment by business to behave ethically, to contribute to economic development while improving the quality of the workforce and their family, as well as local community and society at large. This is the definition given by WBCSD. And if you look at the over a period of time, there is a evolution of CSR with respect to what have been the focus for them. So initially it was profit focus. A company exists only for the short term shareholder profit. Then they moved into the philanthropy, that is passive donation to charities when requested, to community affair, strategic giving linked to the business interest including the cause related marketing, to corporate community investment, that is strategic partnership initiated by company, and finally as a broadly now the way the corporate social responsibility is evolved, they are playing a big role in the sustainable business when it is integrated into business function, goal and strategy. So CSR is not just a part of charity, CSR is not something about doing only community, it is integrated into the business function, goal and strategy. So CSR in India started in 1859 during industrialization. CSR was just about charity and donation, and during independence it was women empowerment and rural development. Then in 2014, this is with our Company Act approved, and for there we got the first country in the world to enact the mandatory minimum CSR spending law. So over a period of time, CSR in India has also evolved with the development of India and moved from charity, philanthropy to women empowerment, rural development and many more focus. And from institutional building it is to community development. So when we talk about CSR, the first name come is the Tata Group. They are the first one to possibly when the name of CSR was not kind of defined, operationalized, they were into the activity what should be the part of the CSR activity. That the first one to establish the labor welfare practices, even before these were made statutory laws across the world. They introduced the 8-hour workday in 1912, the free medical aid they started in 1915, welfare department in 1917, and leave with pay, worker provident fund, worksman compensation in 1920, and maternity benefit for ladies in 1920. So all this information taken, this is adapted from this internet sources on CSR in India, like typically what is the history of CSR in India. This graph shows the recent activity disclosure what have been part of this Futurescape business responsible business report in 2020, and if you look at in the y axis of this graph, the you'll find that the activity what comes under CSR or the activity what the company they have been doing under CSR, those have been listed. And mostly if you look at, it is educational initiative, health and wellness, rural development, environment, livelihood, donation, charity and vocational training. There are many more things where the presence of CSR by the company is still very marginal or very minimal, or also it, we may say this is absent, where they need to pick it up. So, company has have been steadily improved their performance on this count, but you will find that still they are not having enough program in the social space. So, even if the CSR activity is increasing, but then do not have the adequate program in social space. This is the top 10 India, this is the top Indian companies by for CSR. This is from CSR report 2020, and this ranking, this CSR top Indian companies in CSR, this ranking is based on company spending pattern on CSR performance, spending with respect to the responsibility matrix, and also the ESG performance and how companies are incorporating the SDGs into the responsible business action. So, here if you look at, there are presence of manufacturing, there is presence of public sector, there is presence of service sector. So, there is a mix of different company that those are appearing in the top 10 company performing the best in CSR. Let us look one or two company, let us take one or two company and see how they are, how they have performed or what are the activity in the CSR. So, to start with Infosys, the well known company for CSR. It conducts its CSR activity primarily through three trusts: Infosys Foundation in India, Infosys Foundation in USA, and Infosys Science Foundation. These are the focus area, that is healthcare, education, and others. And this is what their prescribed CSR spending and actual spending what they have done in last 5 years, that is 2014-15 to 2018-19. And if you look at whatever they have prescribed for CSR amount, that is mostly they are kind of spending it or close to that, whatever is prescribed and whatever is actual their pay spending for CSR. And this is their CSR highlights, mostly with healthcare and others, initiative or the other activities coming under the CSR. Then coming to the second company, that is ITC, the key stakeholder over here is typically they focuses on rural communities across India, where ITC has the agribusiness operation, and large majority of whom are small and marginal farmers. The community residing in the vicinity of ITC units, mainly rural, but also the semi-rural and also the urban location. They take a horizon strategy, that is through intervention of making current livelihood more productive, profitable and sustainable, and the focus area is primary agriculture and allied activity. Then they have this popular ITC eChopal initiative in the focus of watershed development, afforestation, sustainable agriculture, livestock development and women economic empowerment. Also, ITC's program for education, skilling and vocational training, health sanitation on the solid waste management. This is their water positive status. Then they have partnered with Niti Aayog to improve the agriculture and allied sector in 27 aspirational district. Then eChopal platform to enable the market access and digital driven agri transformation and help 4 million farmers till date. Similarly, coming to the another company, that is Tata Chemical. So, here the CSR program is represented as BCON. BCON is for Blossom, Enhance, Aspire, Conserve and Nurture, and it covers the aspects of health, sanitation, nutrition, livelihood generation, education, environment and biodiversity. And what each of it focuses on, so in Blossom, if you know about the Okhai Center, they have created the Okhai Center for Empowerment, where they give the livelihood to 1500 artisans through skill enhancement training and facilitating the market linkage. And this is one of the successful platform where the sales are increasing in for the handicraft and handloom. That in enhance, under enhance, they are promoting livelihood, agricultural development and the livestock management. Similarly, in Aspire, it focuses the learning and skill development initiative, and similarly for Conserve, it is biodiversity protection, Nurture, it is health and sanitization. And apart from this, this also they focuses on women empowerment and the disaster support. Now, coming to the second part of the session, to understand what is social sustainability. Now, so we know that sustainability has three dimensions: it is economic, it is environment, it is social. But let us try to, because the space, the sphere, it all talks about the social business, social entrepreneurship. In this context, let us understand what is social sustainability. So, social sustainability is the ability of a community to develop process and structure which not only meet the need of its current members, but also support the ability of the future generation to maintain a healthy community. And from the business perspective, it is about understanding the impact of corporation on people and society. In corporation, social sustainability performance issues includes human rights, fair labor practices, and also it gets into community engagement and philanthropy. Now, why there is a growing importance of social sustainability? There is a growing importance of social sustainability because of this query, what the businesses or what the community they face at the business community they face at the different point of time. Are we properly engaging our stakeholder, that is with respect to the stakeholder engagement? The complaint and grievances, are we adequately responding to this? How efficiently we are uplifting the community we directly or indirectly impact, and what is the most effective manner to bring them to the supply chain? Are we investing in the education and health of the young people in our immediate surrounding? And all this thing is also this part of this social sustainability, there is also a standard. So, at some point of time, if the organization want to get a certification or get a certified with respect to their activity of the social sustainability, ISO 26000 that deals with the standard related to social sustainability. So, this is an international standard to develop, to help organization effectively assess and address the social responsibility, and that are relevant and significant to their mission and vision, operations processes, customer, employee, community and stakeholder, and also the impact what they are creating to the ecosystem. Now, let us understand the philosophy behind the social sustainability. This is being presented by many through ethics of social sustainability, the philosophy of social sustainability, and few points from there we have taken here to understand what is the philosophical aspect of the social sustainability. Now, here if you look at the social sustainability, the focus is on individual's behavior, attitude and action. And here the entire social sustainability concept or the philosophy behind social sustainability is to develop the reverse consumerism. That does not mean that we need to end consumption, but understanding the minimalistic requirement for it. So, you will feel that in many cases the minimal or the minimalistic have been a new tagline to understand that how we are concerned for the environment, how we are concerned for the society. But here the social sustainability philosophy, even if they are saying that we should consume less, but it is not about end the consumption, it is about understand what is the minimalistic requirement and accordingly acting over that. The other perspective comes over here is that to understand between the wants and need. So, our basic economics starts with the fact to human wants, and we know that human wants are unlimited. And if we are going to fulfill the unlimited wants, at some point of time we get into the basic economic question that how much resources available and how much is our want, and we always find a gap between the availability of the resources and our unlimited want. So, in that connecting to that, social sustainability, the philosophy behind it is that to understand the difference between wants and need, what we want and actually what we need in life. So, what is necessary instead of what is wanted. And here some of them have given a very radical examples, starvation by choice, to understand the actual need of the starving individual. So, unless we are not starving, possibly we will not know how the hunger or how the starvation is that. Or the second example can be, take the poverty to understand the certain level of built in social expectation. So these are all philosophy, but when it comes to operationalization, we need to see how do we operationalize the reverse consumerism, or how do we operationalize the minimalistic requirement so that it is not affecting the other stakeholder in the process or the other stakeholder in the models. Then there is the different dimensions of social sustainability given by Nobel laureate Amartya Sen. There are 6 dimensions of social sustainability. It starts with the first one is equity. Here the community provides equitable opportunity and outcome for all its members, particularly to the poorest and most vulnerable member of the community. Then diversity, the community promotes and encourages diversity. Interconnected social cohesion, the community provides process, system, structure, promote connectedness with the outside the community in the formal, informal and institutional level. Similarly, the quality of life, the community ensure the basic needs are met to foster a good life for all their members in individual, group and community level with respect to health, housing, education, employment and safety. These are the basic need to lead a good quality of life. Similarly, the other dimension is democracy and governance, like what kind of processes the community is having and also the open and accountable governance structure. And the last one is maturity, that is the individual accept the responsibility of consistent growth improvement through better social attributes, that is through behavioral pattern, indirect education and the philosophical exploration. So the typical example here what we are discussing in the previous slide is to understand by consuming more where I am impacting or which stakeholder is getting impacted. If I am getting minimalistic, whether I am affecting any of the stakeholder in the business processes or in the business model or in the society model. Now these are few of the example, social sustainability example, that is the initiative taken by the company like General Electric matching gift program and healthcare access. And this has become like a popular program. You will find many organizations they have given this. Then IBM, the corporate citizenship, that is 167,000 years of computing time to support projects such as cancer treatment research. 3M gives young scientist challenge. Zappos for good donate the school supplies. Cisco goal is to impact 1 billion people by 2025. Then Apple ask less to planet, the greenest tech company in the world. LinkedIn for good channel to participate in mentorship, donate times and find volunteering opportunity through volunteer marketplace. Sim, you'll find many more examples. This day, this is the organization, they are also seriously putting their effort for the social sustainability. You'll find many more example of the social sustainability in context. Now let's understand, since we have discussed about two things, that is corporate social responsibility and corporate social sustainability, let's understand what may be the difference between CSR and CSS, because we know that in many cases we use it interchangeably, but also there are certain differences that is there between the corporate social responsibility and corporate social sustainability. So here this is one way it is being summarized with respect to vision, target and motivation, and also we will see in the next slide there are other ways where we can make a difference between these two. So here to start with the vision, CSR often looks backward and reflect on what a company has done and contribute to the society, and sustainability typically looks forward and develop a sustainability strategy for the future. Targets, the targets for CSR initiative are often opinion former, that is media, politician and pressure group, whereas corporate system they look at the whole value chain, everyone from the end consumers to the stakeholder. When it comes to motivation, CSR, the driving forces behind CSR initiative is to protect companies' obligation, but for when it comes to CSS, the drive has to more to do with creating new opportunity for the emerging market. Now few more differences between CSR and CSS. So CSR is considered more like a umbrella term under which sustainability is one aspect. Other argue that CSR is the one of the three prong P in the people, planet and profit. Whether they are evolving eventually to become synonym, there are difference between these two. CSR refers to business responsibility to act ethically, consider their impact on community at a large and does not necessarily encompass the sustainability. So, it is they are more on what is the impact on the community. In that process, sustainability may be achieved, sustainability may not be achieved. On the other hand, sustainability concerned with preserving resources in operating in a way that conducive for the long term trading. And here the clear difference between CSR and CSS is that also we discussed in the previous slide, CSR looks backward at performance typically over last 12 months, while sustainability you will find that it is more forward facing focus with a target to secure the future for the trading. Similarly, both CSR and sustainability understand that the context, that each community environment in which business operates, it is integral to business success, and sustainability then goes step further taking into account of the need of the future generation. So, possibly the understanding over here is that the CSR is bother about or the concern about the community environment in which the business is operating, but sustainability is not now also looking at the environment and the community that will happen in the for the future generation or in the future. In business practices, some say CSR is embedded in company's mission and vision, who it is, what it wants to represent, achieve, but sustainability is the day-to-day operation of the company. For example, how to use the energy, that is more like a sustainability. But when you take the same example is that if you are sourcing the energy from which sources, whatever the impact you are making, or sourcing energy if you are able to help any group, any stakeholder, that more about the corporate social responsibility. So, there is a multidimensional view of CSR typically known as 4CR, and it incorporates three interlinked movement in the corporate world, that is CSR, sustainability, worldwide reforms on the corporate governance. So, there is another view is that apart from CSR also there is 4CR, and in 4CR it incorporates the CSR, sustainability and also the corporate governance, which is part of our the newest rise in the ESG. So, here in the last this session we are trying to explore what corporate social responsibility means, how the top Indian company they are doing their CSR, then understanding briefly about social sustainability, what are the different dimensions or what is the philosophical aspect associated with social sustainability, few of the example of social sustainability by the company, and lastly we discuss about the difference between the corporate social responsibility and corporate social sustainability. So, in the next session we will see what are the sustainable development goal and how it can be aligned to the corporate strategy of the organization. Thank you.